Up next, we have Mary, Megan, and Stella.
Looks like you're going to Harvard. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that was my backup school. I ended up choosing between the Ivies.
Between Ivies?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So no public schools, that's it? Like, no new C's?
No.
Do you want me to repeat the question?
No.
Can you repeat that?
Okay, I didn't get into any UCs, okay?
During the college admission process, I picked up some new hobbies. All of the other ones I had before were for the primary purpose of getting into college, so I dropped all those.
Could you give me some examples of the hobbies you picked up?
Yeah, the main one would be checking my email and, my mail. It's just a fun little boost of adrenaline every time I refresh and a new email pops up. And I'm like, oh, it's really satisfying for me. I also started collecting things.
Oh, that's fun. What did you collect?
Letters, postcards, mostly of the college and university variety. Yeah. I read them all super thoroughly, though. I really like receiving mail from colleges I've never heard of and have no interest in. It's really, really nice, really validating for me. They sent me a lot of mail, and it made me feel actually so popular and really, really good about myself. And they seemed to want me really desperately, and then I didn't get in, so that was super fun. So, I want to talk to you a little bit about what you wrote in your essays. Can you walk me through those?
Sure, yeah. I wrote about my experience winning the Nobel Peace Prize. Also a little bit about taking care of my 10 younger siblings, and also raising $1 million for charity. I kind of blended my topics together with a lot of complex metaphors, of course, and a lot of overarching themes of overcoming adversity and fulfilling my true potential.
I wrote about rocks.
Fascinating. Are you into like geology or like a metaphor for something?
Geology, that's like criminology, right? Yeah, no, I just like rocks. I kind of wrote about my pet rock. His name's Steve. He's a real one.
Huh. Do you think that essay was successful?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, got into all my top schools, and Steve too, so yeah, so successful. It rocked. First trial of a new version of the SAT, also known as the Super Amazing Topstickle Course. Today you will be participating in a variety of tests to assess your knowledge.
Yeah? Why are we outside?
Because it's an academic test.
Yeah. This doesn't feel very academic.
What is not academic about this?
It's an obstacle course.
No, it's a super amazing obstacle course.
And this will determine if I get into college.
Yeah. Was Eugene Levy in his movies Fest and Show and Waiting for Guffman, and also his work in Schitt's Creek. I tried to emulate the dry sort of monotone dialogue as well as the comedy where the characters aren't in on the joke but the audience is, and they take themselves seriously, which is funny, but yeah.
Okay, and then we also took inspiration from sitcoms such as The Office, to incorporate casual filming with conversational satire to make it very relatable for our audience.
Nice. My main inspiration was John Krasinski doing a spinning 360 backflip off of what Mary said. Yeah, The Office was a very big inspiration for me, and you know, deadpan deliveries, and John Krasinski's just a genius, so he was my influence. The end. Jeremy.
How did you completely just recreate the college experience?
I'm actually a college admissions advisor. Yeah. Right.
Where's Steve?
Yale. Oh.
I really liked how you really liked the characters, and it felt like actual characters, and I could see, like, it felt like a pilot, like, it was really impressive, like, as well. And also, I really liked the final part of the obstacle course. That was not what I expected at all. I just really liked that one.
Wait, was this pre or it was post-op, huh?
That was post-op, yes. There was, it did get cut, but there was a part where it was supposed to be like, do you have any medical history you need to tell us about? Oh. And I said, I just got spine surgery, so I can't do this obstacle course. And then my admission to Brown was rescinded. It was a really hard time in my life. Luckily, I had my friends with me.
Any lesson of state would take it.
Yeah. Some state.
They actually don't have any colleges.
Maybe you can work on the farm.
Maybe they don't have an education.
They have traits.
I mean, they have that.
You can major in gem making.
Any other questions or comments?
It felt very authentic to the college experience. The rock bit, I was so happy you kept the rock. I remember when your brain started that. I really like Mary's face, how she, like, that, it just, Megan, when you're, like, crying.
The
bike
actually did break.
So you guys, like, it came together really well, and I know there was, like, some challenges in, like, you know, life. But, like, it came together so well in the end. I'm so proud of you guys. Really awesome. So, like, Steve, is he gonna, like, come visit us?
What's his major in
that? Yeah, what's his major?
Is he good for his
criminology?
He's gonna be bad, man.
When can we participate in this super amazing top school course?
You can't.
It's right outside.
No. You're not allowed. Right.
So was the wind in the microphone, that was the purposeful?
It was on purpose.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought. I was
it's
like,
to
went
represent
on.
The hecticness of the like, feeling
overwhelmed by the college admission process. That was so jacking up this year. Right.
I like how you guys chose Megan to do the obstacle course.
Yes.
Yeah. Very good choice.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Anjali?
Yeah. Did you pass?
No.
No. No, I didn't.